Since I began this rebuild series late last year in FIFA 21, there is one team I have been requested to rebuild more than any other, and that is Sheffield Wednesday. Following a points deduction last year, they did get demoted to League One, and they are currently sitting 8th in the league in the 3rd division of English football. And in fairness, that is a position Sheffield Wednesday should not be in. So what we're doing today, we're taking a trip over to Sheffield Wednesday, and we are going to take them from the 3rd tier of English football and take them straight to the top and becoming European champions. If there is a team you want me to rebuild, let me know in the comment section down below. And if you're going to enjoy this video, be sure to leave a like, smash that subscribe button, it really helps out with the growth of the channel. Get some snacks, get some drinks ready, guys, because this is going to take a while. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have yet to see one of my rebuild videos before, here are the rules. The main objective of this rebuild is to win the Champions League. I can make any transfers that I want, making it as realistic as possible. All games have to be simulated, but the Champions League final has to be played. Now that you know how this works, strap yourselves in and enjoy the video. In Season 1, we've been given just over 4 million. And as you guys know, with every single rebuild, I check the Youth Academy and we have stumbled upon an absolute goldmine of a player. Riley Fox, he can play central mid and central attacking midfield. He's 16 years old, he's already 71 rated. This man, we are going to build the team around. We have brought in our very first player for Sheffield Wednesday, Oliver Batista Maia. He cost us just over 1.5 million and he's definitely one for the future. We have brought in yet another player. This time it is Gabriel Salanina, the 17 year old, cost us 1.85 million. We had to activate their release clause because they wouldn't deal with us directly. Very high hopes for this player. Meanwhile, we have just sold Callum Patterson for just under a million. And this guy was never going to stay in Sheffield Wednesday as long as I was in charge. And we have successfully secured Ismael Casas, the right back from Malaga CF, for just over 2.5 million. That wraps up that first transfer window. This is how the team is looking. And not going to lie, it looks quite decent. I'm aware that all I've done is bring in youngsters. But the thing is, I have tried so goddamn hard to go for players that are in the mid-20s, like 25 plus. Nobody wants to come to Sheffield Wednesday. Nobody will relocate and nobody wants to drop down from a higher league to the third tier division of English football. It just won't happen, so I've had no choice. But anyway, I'm quite happy with how this team's looking. I'm very excited to see what this guy's capable of. Batista Maia, 20 years old, 66 rated. I reckon him and Fox are definitely going to be built around in this team. As for what I want to accomplish this season, I'm not even too sure. I'm not even going to lie to you. I don't know where we really stand in terms of how good we are compared to other teams in this league. I know I've rebuilt Sunderland already, but that doesn't mean I'm familiar with the teams in there at all. We'll get to the halfway point and then we'll have a look at it from there. So we are at the midway point of this season. We're currently sitting 8th place in the league. Now, to be fair, that looks a lot worse than it actually is because there's only 3 points that separate us from 4th place Rotherham United, so it's not actually that bad. In fairness, there's only 6 points that separate ourselves from 1st place Portsmouth, so realistically, we are doing pretty well. And that is the end of that transfer window. We did absolutely nothing, to be fair, because we were absolutely broke. Nobody came in for any of our players, so we literally just skipped the entire transfer window and did nothing. But there are visible improvements in this starting 11. Pretty much everybody's gone up in overalls. Hopefully in this second half of the season, we can see our form spike a little bit. Hopefully we can rise in the table. Hopefully our players will continue to improve, but we're gonna have to wait until the end of the season to find out. So we have reached the end of this season and we have dramatically improved our form. We reached the top 4, so I do believe that means we were in the playoffs with Rotherham, MK Dons and Oxford to determine who goes into the championship. So let's see if we made it into the championship. Oh no! MK Dons knocked us out 3-1 on aggregate. That is absolutely gut-wrenching. We remain in the third tier of English football for another season, but I'm not gonna lie, if the team's improved as much as I think it will have, we will absolutely storm League One next season. It was Oxford United in the end who did get promoted to the championship, so congratulations to them. So it was Portsmouth, Charlton and Oxford this time getting promoted to the championship. Fair play to them, but next year that will be us. Meanwhile, it was Arsenal this time who won the FA Cup. It was Liverpool who won the Carabao Cup against Preston. Bloody hell, Preston had a good run. It was Swindon Town who won the Papa John's Trophy. Deportivo Alaves won the Europa Conference League. Bayern Munich ended up winning going in the Europa League. What is Bayern Munich and Atletico Madrid doing in the Europa League? And it was Sevilla of all teams to be crowned champion. What is going on this season? Our top goal scorer this season, Cambry, was on loan for us. So next season, our top priority will probably be getting a striker, unless there's one in the squad that we haven't quite found yet, which could suit the bill. Looking at the stats, though, oh, I'm dead happy with this guy. Batista Maia, he's got up 5 overall, 21 years old. I can see this guy being pretty decent in the future. I think that all the signings that I've made so far, oh, look at this guy. Riley Fox has gone to 76 rated. We have definitely got to keep him for as long as we possibly can. He is going to be so important to us for the next 2 or 3 seasons. But like I say, season 2, we need to find a striker unless we've got one in the ranks that we haven't discovered yet. But in season 2, we definitely need to make smart signings. In our second season, we'd be given just over 6 million. We have signed Carl Starfelt from Celtic for just under 4 million. We've just picked up Izzy Brown on a free. We have also just picked up Papa Cech Diop on a free as well. And that is the end of that transfer window. This is how the team is looking going into the first half of season 2. And I'm quite confident that we can do really well. I'm really excited to see how high this guy goes up this season. I mean, I've got a good feeling we can reach the 80 overall mark before this season's over. But really this year, I am looking at automatic promotion. I don't really want anything less. Failing that, we need to be hitting at least the playoffs. While at the midway point this season, we're in second spot, only 5 points behind first place Rotherham United, so he's looking exceptionally good, to be fair. We're doing a hell of a lot better than we were doing this time last season, put it that way. Again, we did nothing in that transfer window because, well, we're broke from bringing in Starfelt and nobody else came in for any of the players. We didn't do anything because there was no money to do anything with. But I'm quite confident by the end of this season, will be in the championship. It is the end of the season and we are in the championship. We have gone from League One as champions, followed exceptionally close by Rotherham United. It was really close between us. It was a two-horse race from beginning to end, to be fair. So it's between Accrington Stanley, Bolton, Hull City and Sunderland in regards to who goes up with us. And it was Accrington Stanley. I did not see that one coming. So it is ourselves, Rotherham and Accrington Stanley promoted to the championship. Meanwhile, Manchester United won the FA Cup. Chelsea won the Carabao Cup. We ended up winning the Papa John's Trophy. Wolfsburg won the Europa Conference League. Olympic Lyon won the Europa League. And Chelsea won the Champions League. To cut a long story short, guys, it was a really successful season this time. But my only worry is, are we good enough to compete in the championship? I think we'll definitely go in after upgrade certain positions, but I'm hoping that because we've been promoted to the championship, we'll get like 10 to 15 million to work with, but we're going to have to wait until next season to find out. Either way, going to be a tricky season. In season 3, we've been given just over 8 million. I really don't know why it won't let me show you even on the transfer history, but we have picked up Humberto Perez on a free. We've definitely done well to get this man. We have brought in Wahid Fegir for 7 million. Definitely brought one for the future here. And that does wrap up that transfer window. This is how the team is looking going into the championship this season. But I must admit, we've got quite a strong team here as well. There's not really any weak links. Fox is definitely running the show. 18 years old, 82 rated. This man is going to be a baller in the next couple of seasons. One of our main objectives is to fight for promotion, and I reckon we've got a good shot at making the playoffs this time. We definitely won't gain automatic promotion. I don't think we're quite strong enough for that, but we'll definitely make the playoffs. So at the midway point of this season as it stands, we're currently in the top 8. We're only 4 points outside of the playoffs, which, to be fair, it's half decent for a first season in the championship. But I definitely think that in the second half of the season, we can pull it out of the bag and get the playoffs. Right, we do have some catching up to do. So firstly, we have been in the free agent department for a bit this time. We have brought in Arnaud Tanas, Ismaili Bora and Isaac Gregory all on a free. We have also just brought in Eusebio Moreira on a free as well. Meanwhile, we have just sold Izzy Brown for just over 3 million. Definitely the best transfer we have done this transfer window. We have brought in Kiau Teixeira on a free, 20 years old, 75 rated. And that is the end of that transfer window. And it is a very successful transfer window as well. We brought in squad depth, brought in a lot of quality too. It does fill me with confidence going into the second half of the season, man. I mean, if we make the playoffs, I don't think it'd be in our best interests if we actually got promoted. I mean, we wouldn't have the best budget to work with. We would need upgrades on the wings. We'd need another centre back. We'd definitely need a better keeper. I think our best interest is to stay in the championship for one more season. That's not me hoping for failure. That's me prolonging short-term success for long-term success. I think it's safe to say that this is a season we can class as a failure. We didn't even make the playoffs this time, which shocked me, to be fair, because I thought our team was definitely strong enough to make the playoffs. But it does mean that next season we do have to buy very smartly to improve the team. Meanwhile, it was Chelsea who won the FA Cup, Arsenal won the Carabao Cup, Bill won the Europa Conference League, Real Sociedad won the Europa League, and it was Atletico Madrid who taught Chelsea a lesson in the Champions League final, and they were crowned champions of Europe. So this time it was Bournemouth and Stoke City who were promoted. Now let's see who joined them. It was out of Watford, Sheffield, Blackburn Rovers and Norwich. Now, if I had to put my money on any of them teams, it would most likely be Norwich or Watford. Let's find out. It was Norwich in the end who were promoted, so I was right. So it is Norwich, Bournemouth and Stoke City rejoining the Premier League. All things considered, I think staying in the Championship for another season was probably the best thing we could have done for long-term success. If we'd have been promoted this time, we'd have had a 72-rated winger, a 73-rated winger. If we'd have been promoted this time, there's no way in hell we'd have being able to compete. Riley Fox, oh my God, what a player this guy's turned out to be for us. Thing is though, now I know exactly where I need to buy for in order to be successful next season. So we begin this season somehow with a lot more budget to work with. We've been given just over 10 million. We have begun this transfer window by making a very big signing. We have brought in Peter from Real Madrid for just under 5 million. And on top of that, we have brought in a brand new centre back by the name of Mark O'Connor, again for just over 4.5 million. Meanwhile, we have just sold a couple of players. First one being Josh Windass for just over 2.1 million. And Dennis Adeniran has just also been sold for just over 2 million. And our last bit of business for this transfer window was selling the guy that we brought in, I believe at the very start of this rebuild, Oliver Batista-Meyer. We have just sold him for just under 12 million. And that is the end of that transfer window. And I'm not going to lie, taking a very quick look at this team, I'm pretty sure we've got promotion in the bag this time. I know I said that last season, but this is a much improved team. We have brought in Peter. We're giving Eusebio Moreira a go where Batista used to be. Figuia is legitimately going to carry us this season, I think. Him and Fox are definitely going to carry us. Only thing we really need to do in the second transfer window is probably buy another winger, but the money we did get for Batista will probably help a lot in doing that. So we are at the midway point of this season now, and we are currently sitting pretty top of the table, 3 points clear of second place Brentford, and we are 4 points clear of our neighbours Sheffield United. That's got to feel good for you Sheffield Wednesday fans. We have brought in Tomas Araujo from Arsenal for £8 million. We have also found our winger Alex Martin. We picked him up on a free. And we've also picked up this man, Sergio Arribas, on a free as well. And that is the end of that transfer window. This is how the team is looking going into the second half of this season. And I've got to say, I am really confident about us getting promoted automatically this time. I can't see how it doesn't happen. I'd even argue that once our signings do get a bit of growth, do get a bit of improvement, that next season we'll actually hold our own in the Premier League if we do get promoted. But we have to get there first. So let's go to the end of this season and find out if we did get promotion. So we ended up getting automatic promotion. We were 1 point off going up as champions, so West Brom just beat us to the post. In the playoffs, it is Brentford, Burnley, Watford and Sheffield. Oh my God, that is a tough lot. I can't even call you go up from that. I reckon Brentford have got this one in the bag. Wow, that surprised me. So Sheffield United do remain in the Championship for another season, but Burnley are promoted along with ourselves and West Brom. So Burnley, West Brom and Sheffield Wednesday are back in the Premier League. Meanwhile, it was Brighton this time who won the FA Cup, Liverpool won the Carabao Cup, Roma won the Europa Conference League, Spurs won the Europa League, and it was Real Madrid this time crowned champions of Europe. I'm saying this now, Figuia is going to be decent in the Premier League next season. I reckon he'll carry us quite badly next season. I think we'll hold our own. I reckon it's going to be a bottom half finish, not relegation, but bottom half finish, but he's definitely going to be a vital part of us staying up. Along with Riley Fox, now I think I'm going to stick him on the transfer list next season because the money that we could get for this guy, let's have a look at how much he's actually worth. His value is 155 million, so realistically we could get about 190 to 240 million for him. Spread that across the entirety of the team and we, in two seasons time, have probably got a European caliber team. But we are in the big boy league now, we are in the Premier League, so hopefully our budget can help us a little bit in gaining the players that we do need to compete in the Premier League. This time, we've been given a hell of a lot more money. We've been given just under £40 million. And our third point of business this transfer window was bringing in Salvatore Gatti from Brentford for £8 million on the dot. And we have broken the bank to bring this guy in. We have brought Romain Perrard in. The left-back cost us £28 million. We have just sold Jadon Brown for £1.4 million. And that does wrap up that transfer window. This is the team going into the first season in the Premier League. Now, I must admit, I'm a little disappointed nobody came in for Fox. I did put him up for the transfer list, but obviously no one came in for him. I don't think anybody's going to splash the cash on him just yet. But I've still got hope for the second transfer window of this season. But if I'm going to be totally honest, I think this season we're definitely going to struggle, but I do think we will survive. If we can be in between 14th and 10th place by the midway point of this season, I'll be quite happy with that. You know what? I'll take that. 15th place in the Premier League for the first half of the season isn't bad at all when you consider Arsenal are 17th. It is literally always Arsenal who are doing shit, isn't it? Saying that, Spurs aren't exactly doing well either. They're 13th too. So 15th place for our first season in the Premier League isn't bad at all. Guys, it has finally happened. Our youngster from the beginning who got us through promotion after promotion to the Premier League, we have finally got rid of him. Riley Fox has been sold to Paris Saint-Germain for £237 million. Now the makeover begins. Our first bit of business is bringing in Edouard Mendy from Chelsea for £22 million. This guy is probably one of my favourite keepers in the world at the minute, so I'm dead happy I got him for Sheffield Wednesday. Our next signing is Juroš Rakitić. He's come from Bayer Leverkusen and he cost us £36 million. We definitely spent big to bring in this man, the centre-back Josko Vardiol, £67.6 million to bring away from Köln. Our next signing, we have brought in the attacking midfielder Nabil Fekir for £35 million on the dot. Now, anybody who knows me knows how much I love this guy, so I am buzzing to get him into the team. And we have brought in the Swedish youngster Anthony Elanga for just under £32 million. So, after an exceptionally busy transfer period, this is how the team is looking. And I've got to say, I am so much more confident going into this second half of the season than I was before. Some of you are probably thinking that I was cheating by selling Fox, but let's be honest, if that was a real-life situation and there was a player that good in a team that was in the bottom half of the Premier League, you'd cash in, wouldn't you? But like I say, I'm very confident going into the second half of the season now. I reckon we'd definitely save from relegation at this point. We do end up finishing in the top 10, which I am absolutely buzzing with. We're only 3 points away from European football, which does mean that we have taken a massive stride in the right direction. Arsenal were 5 points from relegation in the end as well. Arsenal, what the hell is going on with you? Meanwhile, it was Tottenham Hotspur who won the FA Cup. It was Brighton who beat Chelsea to win the Carabao Cup. Real Sociedad won the Europa Conference League. Bayern Munich won the Europa League. And it was Real Madrid who were crowned champions of Europe. I told you it would be this man who'd carry us this season. And this man has gone up to 86 rated at only 22 years of age. 19 goals and 6 assists and 44 apps in his first season in the Premier League isn't bad going in the slightest. It's promising signs for the next season in the Premier League. Now with the team that we've got, I want to be hitting European football. That is the goal for next season. We begin this season with £37.3 million. And we kickstart this transfer window by bringing in Fred on a free. We have bolted our midfield by bringing in Bentancourt for £37 million. This is exactly why you guys need to look at your free agents at the start of every single season. You never know who you can pick up. We have picked up Maxim Fischer, the 19-year-old central attacking midfielder, on a free. Already 81 rated, we've definitely got a gold mine here. Meanwhile, we have just sold Isaac Gregory for £5.7 million. We have just sold Papacek Diop for £9 million. And that is the end of that transfer window. This is how the team is looking, and it is mental how one sale last year has transformed this team into an actual monstrosity. I'll be very disappointed this year if we don't manage to get Champions League football, man. That is the goal with this team. Especially with the acquisition of Fish, I've got a lot of hope for this guy. But I guess only time will tell in the end. Well, when you compare this season to last season, we have certainly leveled up. We are 3 points behind top place. Actually, hang on a minute. Brighton the top, We're second. This is definitely a crazy season. And Arsenal are 16th, so actually it's not that crazy after all. But we have taken a massive stride in the right direction, considering this time last season we're in the bottom half and now we're in the top four, which is exactly where I want to be. Our first bit of business in this transfer window is selling Nabil Fekir for $49.2 million. We have brought in a brand new centre-back by the name of Odilon Kusunu for the region of £51 million. And that is the end of that transfer window, and this is how the team is looking going into the remainder of this season. And I've got to say, I am exceptionally confident we're getting Champions League football next season with this team. Fisher, 20 years old, 84 rated. I can't believe we got this guy on a free. What an absolute bargain this was. The only place I really want to buy in for next season and improve is this left winger role. Now, we've got Martin and we've got Peter. Both decent options, but they're both 81 and 80 rated. Next season, I want someone a lot higher rated than that. Hopefully, by the end of this season, we have got Champions League football. So let's find out. Well, it's official. We have got Champions League football for next season, which means two things. Number one, we've definitely got to improve our left winger position. And number two, we have surely got to have a much better budget to work with next season as well, which is only going to help in buying a better left winger. Meanwhile, it was Liverpool who won the FA Cup, beating us in the process to do it. Liverpool also won the Carabao Cup. Man City won the Europa Conference League. Inter Milan won the Europa League. And it was Juventus this time who were crowned champions of Europe. To say I'm buzzing with this guy is an understatement. 20 years old, 85 rated. What an absolute baller this guy's turned out to be. Always look for your free agents at the start of every transfer window, man. Honest to God, you never know who you can get. Alanga and Fekir definitely carried this team this season. 27 goals for Alanga, 4 assists. 26 goals for Fekir and 9 assists. The boys have just done an absolute madness this time. I can't wait for next season, man. The first season in the Champions League with Sheffield Wednesday. Bring it on. We begin this season with just over £91 million. I said at the end of last season we needed to bring in a better winger, and we have done just that. We have brought in Callum Hudson-Odoi from Chelsea for the region of £86 million. We have just strengthened our midfield massively by bringing in Lorenzo Pellegrini on a free. And that is the end of that transfer window. This is the team that we are taking into the first half of the season. This is the team we're taking into the Champions League. There's a very good chance that we could actually pull this one out of the bag this season alone, depending on obviously who we're drawn against in the group stage. If we pass the group stage, it depends on who we draw in the knockout stages. Literally, there's so many variables that come into this, but I genuinely think with this team, we've got a good chance of winning it. We are in Group H and we are joined by Wolfsburg, Club Brugge and Spartak Moscow. Don't care if in the past it's shafted me before, we've got to storm this group. There's no other alternative. If we don't finish first with 5 wins in the draw or 6 out of 6 wins, there's something really wrong. Well, we almost topped it how I wanted to. We won 4, drew 1, lost 1. We made it through on goal difference. I'm assuming that we topped the table over Wolfsburg, even though we're on the same sort of stats like goal difference wise. It's purely because when we played them, we must have had a better goal difference against them when we played them. But it is Wolfsburg and ourselves going through to the round of 16. Let's hope we get a nice team to play against next. And it is Villarreal. So it is quite a nice round of 16 fixture to go into. And in the Premier League, we are top 4 once again, 6 points behind league leaders Manchester City, 2 points behind second place Liverpool. Brighton are again up there with us. Brighton must have an absolutely ridiculous team. And once again, Arsenal are in the bottom 10 of the Premier League. I'm loving this rebuild just for that reason alone, honestly. That is the end of that transfer window. We did absolutely nothing because, quite frankly, nobody came in for any of the players, and we've got no money to go in for anybody else's players, so the team does remain the same going into the round of 16 tie against Villarreal, which I'm not going to lie, I'm very confident we're going to absolutely smash them up. When you take a look at Villarreal's team in comparison to ours, there should be no contest in this. We should walk all over these guys with ease. We're away from home in the first leg, so hopefully we can get a win under a belt and take it into the second leg, which we do courtesy of Alanga and Hudson-Odoi's goals. We go into the second leg quite comfortably in the lead. We aren't going to mess around. We're just going to get this second tie over and done with. We're 2-0 up anyway, so really, there we go. 4-1 on aggregate, 2-1 in the second leg. We very comfortably progress to the next round. It's a very rare occasion where we play against Napoli in the knockout stages of the Champions League. Normally, when we play against Napoli, it's always in the final. I don't think we've ever actually come up against them in the round of 16 or the quarters or anything like that, but we're at home in this first leg tie, so hopefully it's just the same as Villarreal. We can get a decent lead. No, we go 1-0 down. All right, that is a shocking scene of events. I thought we'd have quite comfortably had like a 2-0 win or something there, but yeah, okay, fair enough. We go into the second leg 1-0 down with a hell of a lot of work to do. Okay, I'll be the first one to admit, I definitely underestimated Napoli. I didn't think they stood a chance against us. I ain't gonna lie to you, but that's in the first leg. It's done and dusty. My cockiness is out the window. What matters now is that in the second leg, we find our form and Sheffield Wednesday boot their place in the next round of the Champions League, which we do. We do it successfully. Pellegrini, Rakic and Fegui with the goals to get our place in the semi-finals. This is definitely a fixture I never thought I'd say out loud. It's Sheffield Wednesday versus Barcelona in the semi-finals of the Champions League. We're at home in the first leg, and I've got to tell you, I do fancy my chances against Barcelona. We've just beaten Napoli, we beat Sevilla, now it's time to knock out Barcelona. Come on, boys, let's do it. Okay. So it's 2-2. It is literally all to play for in the second leg. We're one game away from potentially being knocked out in the semis or gaining entry to the Champions League final. Easily the biggest game of this rebuild video so far, man. Honestly, when you look at the two teams as well, to be fair, they're so evenly matched, man. All around the pitch, it's definitely a true clash of titans. I think it's going to come down to who wants it more, and I've got an inkling that the Sheffield Wednesday boys want it a little bit more than the Spanish giants. So, let's see if I'm right. Can we book our place in the... Come on! Yes, we do it! 5-2 on aggregate, it finishes 3-0 to the Sheffield Wednesday boys. We are in the Champions League final. So against all odds, it's actually an all-English final. It is Leicester City versus Sheffield Wednesday in the Champions League final. These finals just get crazier every time, man. But before we get into the final itself, let's check how we've done this season. We finished second in the Premier League, Manchester City. Jesus Christ, they really did run away with it in the end. They were 11 points clear of us by the end of the season. That is, Man City are just in a league of their own when it comes to these rebuilds sometimes. Then it was Leicester City, then Liverpool, Everton, Brighton, Spurs and Southampton who gained entry to Europe this time. So, okay, so you got United who finished 9th, you got Chelsea who finished 12th, then Arsenal who finished 16th. Honestly, these boys just don't know what the hell they're doing in these rebuild videos, do they? It was Palace who beat West Ham to win the FA Cup. Manchester City won the Carabao Cup. It was Hertha Berlin who won the Europa Conference League. And Manchester City did end up gaining the treble by winning the Europa League. So, five of our players got double figures when it came to goals, man. Elanga, Fekir, Hudson-Odoi, Fisher, Pellegrini as well from the bench did bloody brilliant. Fair play. He was a really good signing for a free. I'm so impressed with how Fekir has done since we signed him. Signed him all the way back in, I think it was season 2 or season 3, and he was only at 73 rated, and he's grown to 90 rated overall. Ridiculously happy with how this guy did. Ismael Casas, I think we signed him in season 2 as well, and he was like 70 rated when we bought him, and he's now 83 rated. And it's mad to think that most of these signings came from the sale of one player as well. If we hadn't sold him, I still think we'd have been fighting for survival in the Premier League. As much as I wanted to keep Fox, it was definitely the smarter move to sell him in the end. Overall though, we've had a really goddamn good season. Second in the Premier League, and we are in the Champions League final. Now, I ain't gonna lie to you guys, when I originally saw that we were playing against Leicester City in the final of the Champions League, I was kind of like, yeah, okay, we can definitely, it's an easy game. But when you take a look at that starting 11, they've definitely got a couple of players we've got to watch out for. They've got Evanilson, they've got Smith Rowe, Camavinga, Militao, Gineppo. Definitely some players on that team that deserve to be in this Champions League final. But nevertheless, I'm about to say a sentence I've never thought I'd ever say. It is Leicester City versus Sheffield Wednesday at the Bernabeu in the Champions League final. Right, Leicester, let's see what you've got. Fagir is on the ball, man. Fagir, what a player this is. Oh, hang on. Oh, no, why would you put it there? Hang on, we've recovered quite well, though. Can we get it to Fagir? Fagir, on his left. Oh, come on. If you'd have just put that to Fisher in the first place, that would have been 1-0 there. Oh, no. Oh, where's our defence? Where is our defence here? Gineppo. Oh, my God. Oh, what a save from Mendy. That is why I bought Mendy to begin with. Mendy is an absolute menace in between them sticks. Oh, my God. What a ball. Oh, this is all you. This is all you, Alanga. Oh, wait, what? Is that a penalty? We got a penalty. Come on. We just can't afford to miss. We cannot afford to miss. Oh, the power beat him. We make it 1-0 courtesy of a Bentancur penalty. Callum Hudson-Odoi. Oh, we forced the save. I tell you what, he could not get the ball off Hudson-Odoi then, could he? And that is the last kick before half-time. And we go into the half-time break 1-0 to the good, courtesy of a penalty from Bentancur. To be fair, we don't deserve to be... Neither of us deserve to be winning, really. I mean, it's been quite an even game. Rekica's on the ball. Can he find... Oh, beautiful. Fisher. Can we find Fagir in the middle? Yes, first time, and that is 2-0. I am pretty sure that this is game over now. Sheffield Wednesday have got a 2-0 lead after the 60th minute in the Champions League final. Beautiful run this was by Fisher. Beautiful 1-2. Fagir knew where he wanted it. First time, bang, top left bins. Literally no chance for the keeper, and this is pretty much done and dusted now. Perud has got the ball. Can he find Hudson-Odoi? Oh my God, the ball's gone all the way through. The ball has gone all the way through. It's Hudson-Odoi. It is Hudson-Odoi. Why is he taking that on his left foot? The absolute donkey. Hudson-Odoi. Oh my God, what a ball. Can we do... I thought the keeper was coming out. What an idiot. Okay, what has just happened? Oh my God, what a save from Mendy. Oh, that's why I bought him, man. That's why I bought him. The clean sheet merchant. Tell you what, Leicester are putting on the pressure now, and it is showing. There's 5 minutes left in this game, and Leicester City have just pulled one back. This is legitimately squeaky bum time now. Fahir has found Hudson-Odoi. He's lost it. Oh, do not give them chance to have a counter-attack. Snap him. Take him out completely. Take them out. Oh, no. Vardiol. Oh, my. Hang on. Is that the final whistle? Come on. That's the final whistle. Sheffield Wednesday have officially been crowned champions of Europe. Courtesy of a penalty from Bentancur and a goal from the Starman Fagir. Sheffield Wednesday have put their name in the history book as winners of the Champions League. Let me know in the comments down below what team you want me to rebuild next. As you can see, I am open to any and all teams. Just give me a little bit of time to do them. That's all I ask. And if you did go on to enjoy this video, be sure to leave a like. Smash the ever-living shit out of that subscribe button. It really does help with the growth of the channel. You guys are absolutely loving these rebuild videos, so I'm going to keep them coming as long as you keep liking them. That is all from me. It has been your boy Goodwin. Hope you guys have a fantastic day, and until next time, I'll see you later.